this episode, I'll show you how to save hard drive space and battery power by using smart previews in Lightroom.
Autorama TV presents Exploring Photography with Mark Wallace.
Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Exploring Photography right here on Adorama TV. It's brought to you by Adorama. It's the camera store that has everything for photographers. It's the place where I get all my stuff. You should check them out at adorama.com. Well, I'm hanging out in the lobby of the hostel here in Lima, Peru. It's a little bit noisy. We're sort of outside and I'm using my laptop here, and we're doing this because really that's what I'm going to be talking about in this episode. It's for photographers that are on the go, maybe wedding photographers, location shooters that use laptops a lot and also love to use Lightroom. One of the things that I do, and I know a lot of you do as well, is when you're using Lightroom, you're storing your images on an external hard drive. And you do that because your internal hard drive doesn't have a lot of space, and so it really makes sense to throw things on an external hard drive, maybe have a backup out there. It really works well. But one of the disadvantages of having an external hard drive means that you always have to have this thing connected to your laptop to edit your images in Lightroom. Well, that can really drain the battery if you're not connected to an external power source, because we all know these external hard drives can really run the battery down quickly. And if you're working on a plane or a train or in a lobby somewhere, that really doesn't make sense. Well, there's a nice thing called Smart Previews in Lightroom, and what they do is they allow you to store your images on the external hard drive, but then you can disconnect that external hard drive and still edit the images on your local hard drive. Now, I know that sounds too good to be true, but it really is true, and they're really easy to use. So that's what we're going to be talking about in this episode. But before we do that, I want to remind you that Adorama has some terrific contests and you can win some awesome prizes. So click the link and enter the contest today. Let me tell you about my setup. I have my Lightroom catalog in a folder on my desktop called My Lightroom Catalog, and all of my images are on my external hard drive. This is my LaCie Rugged hard drive, and they're stored in a folder called My Photos. So my catalog is here, my external hard drive has all my photos here. Well, now that we know about that, let's dive in and take a closer look. Well, here's what I was talking about. We have the Lightroom catalog on my local hard drive on my laptop. And then we have a video drive. I open that up. I've got a folder here called My Photos. And inside that, we have all the photos that my Lightroom catalog is referencing. So the photos are on the external hard drive. The catalog is on the internal hard drive on my laptop. So let's just go ahead and open my Lightroom catalog. Lightroom 5 opens up. And I've got some images here that I've taken along my travels here in South America so far. And what we're going to do here is we're just going to take a look at this little iguana that I shot in the Galapagos Islands. Now, when I zoom in here, I'll zoom in. You can see all the details on his nose. He looks great. And what we see here underneath the histogram is this icon that says original photo. And if I go to the grid view, you'll see that there aren't any icons up on the thumbnails. We just got some standard stuff that we're used to. Now, watch what happens here when I disconnect my external hard drive. So I'll go over and I'm going to eject the video drive, the external hard drive, and I'm going to actually disconnect it from my laptop. And so there is no connection now between Lightroom and my external hard drive. All of a sudden, we see these little exclamation points that show up, these little icons. And if you hover over that, it's saying, hey, this photo is missing. The connection has been lost between the catalog and the external file. And if we open this up and let's try to go over, let's say, to the develop module, notice we also have no histogram, that's gone. There's a little icon here that says this photo is missing. If we go over to the develop module and we try to do some editing here, we get an error message that says this file could not be found. There's no ability for us to do any image adjustments here, that's all grayed out. So we can't do anything because the photo is missing, and that's no good. So what we'll do is let's plug in the external hard drive again. We'll reestablish the connection between the catalog and the external hard drive. That happens automatically. So now that I have my external hard drive plugged in, we'll see that these little icons go away, and we'll see that the original photo little icon shows up under the histogram again. We're all good. We can go into the develop module, and everything's working as expected. Well, I really want to edit these photos without having my external hard drive connected, and so I'm going to create a smart preview. I'm going to do that for one file right now. That's this iguana here. I can do that by going over here to this little icon that says original photo. I can do that in the library module or the develop module. It doesn't matter. I'll just click that, And then it gives me an option to create a smart preview. So I'm going to do that. The smart preview is going to be created. And now look, we have a different icon. It says original plus smart preview. So we know that we have both things going on. And so when we go back to the grid view, we have two different. We have this guy here. It's got a smart preview and everything else that doesn't. So let's disconnect our external hard drive and see what happens now. So now our external hard drive is disconnected, and check it out. When we go back to our Lightroom catalog, we'll see that now these guys that don't have smart previews created have the same old, hey, this file is missing icon, but this guy has a little icon that's different, and it says, hey, I've got a smart preview. And we can see over here underneath the histogram, we've got an icon that says smart preview. And now what we can do is let's go in and actually go to the develop module. Check it out. We can still edit. We can edit now on the smart preview. In fact, let's do something crazy with this photo here. Let's really go in and make it different. So we'll make it black and white. We'll make it super contrasty. Let's increase the exposure a little bit. So we've made some huge changes. It's no longer in color. So obviously this is different. And let's actually change some pixels. Let's take his eyeball and let's fix it. We'll give him, I don't know, skin over the eyeball there. So we're actually doing some edits that we would normally need that external reference for this to work. We don't need it anymore. We're editing using the smart preview. Now, the neat thing is these smart previews are large enough that we can do some exporting. So I can go in here and say export, and I'm going to create one that's a 1200 pixel JPEG image that was created for Facebook. It's a preset that I've already built. Check it out. I can actually do exporting and all kinds of things. Now, you can't do full size exporting. You can't export the original image because obviously it doesn't exist. If you want to do robust editing in Photoshop, you can't do that. So there are some limited things you can do. In fact, if I right click this and try to edit this in Photoshop, see there, it's all grayed out. You can't do that. So there are some limitations to the smart preview, but you do have a lot of power. Check it out. This guy here has no smart preview. If I want to go to the develop module and do some stuff, I still get that file not found. File is missing. So we've got the normal issue. So the smart preview really helps out. And the other thing that's really nice is you don't have to build smart previews for every file. You can just build those previews for the ones that you want to use. Well, let's connect our external hard drive again. As soon as we do that, the edits that we've made to our smart preview are automatically applied to the original image. So if you do want to go to, let's say, Photoshop and do some editing, well, all the stuff that you did on the smart preview will show up. So check it out. Now that we're connected again, I will right click, say edit in Photoshop. Photoshop is going to open and the Iguana will actually open. And remember, we did that edit to the eyeball where I sort of masked over the eyeball. Watch this. It's going to show up. Sure enough, there's our crazy eye that I created in Lightroom on the smart preview, totally disconnected from our original file. And that is awesome. Well, what about the options for creating the smart previews? Well, we've already shown you one, and that is using the icon just to click each image individually to create those. The other way you can do that, there's two other ways. We can go up here to the library, and then we can say previews, build smart previews. Once you click on that, you get the choice to either build one, so you can say, hey, I just want this image to have a smart preview, or you can build all of them, and your entire catalog will have smart previews. There's that. The way that I do it, and I think it's the best way, is when you import your images, you have an option to create smart previews on import. So I just inserted a card here. We see some images that I just shot here in Lima. We'll just take these this one image here. Up on the right side in the preview window, you'll see this little thing that says build smart previews. Make sure that's checked. And if it is, when you import your file, the file will be imported. And as soon as it's imported, that smart preview will be built. Now remember, if you're importing a lot of files, building smart previews will take a while. So you're going to add a few minutes to your import. If there are hundreds of files, maybe enough time to go get a coffee. It'll take a little while. But now we can see that we have an original plus a smart preview, which is really, really awesome. All right, well, the last thing we want to do is check to see what are the file size differences between the smart previews on the local hard drive and the external original files. So to see that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the library and I'm going to say previews, build smart previews, and I'm going to build all of these. And by the magic of editing in post-production, we'll see those all built. So let me do that and we'll show you the size differences. Well, all of our smart previews have been built. Now I want to minimize this, and what we'll do is we'll go back to the desktop here and take a look at the differences between my Lightroom catalog. So I'm going to get the info, and we see that's 130 megabytes with all of the smart previews built, which is pretty crazy. If I open this and take a look at my photos, it's 2.1 gigabytes. And so there is a massive difference in the size of the smart previews that you can use in your Lightroom catalog and the external files that you would have on your external hard drive. And so you're saving a ton of space. Now, the other thing that's really awesome is if you don't even want to have the smart previews, you can always go into Library, Previews, and you can discard the smart previews. And so you can discard one at a time to get rid of things that you're not using, or you can get rid of all of them. And so you have the options to manage your storage on your local hard drive as you see fit. And that is something that is really awesome. So you've got the ability to edit without being connected to your external hard drive. And that is a huge win, in my opinion. Well, you can see that smart previews are a huge benefit to anybody that is storing their images on an external hard drive. Check them out. They're easy to use, and I hope this episode helped. Now, don't forget, you can subscribe to Adorama TV absolutely free. So click on the link and subscribe today, and I'll see you again in the next episode.
Great looking prints at low cost? Be sure to visit our easy to use online printing service. Adorama Pix has professionals who treat your images with the utmost care that you can count on. For a quick turnaround on photos, cards, or albums, use adoramapix.com.